Please forgive me now if, by chance, I wrongly pronounced the names and words in this video. Serial killers commit incidents of homicide in separate events and crime scenes. They would experience periods of emotional cooling where they would return to their normal lives. This can last for weeks, months, or even years. Today, I will be telling you about the first serial killer recorded in historical archive. This does not mean he was the first serial killer, but just the first to be recorded that we know about currently. Liu Pingli was the third son of Liu Wu, the grandson of Emperor Wen, and the nephew of Emperor Jin. He also had four brothers. In the year 144 BCE, his father would die of an illness, and his mother became inconsolable. Emperor Jin, his uncle, placated her by dividing the realm of Lian to five pieces and bestowing them upon Liu Wu's sons. Liu Pingli would become Prince of Jidong, and he ruled here from 144 to 121 BCE. It was during this time period at which Sima Qian, records of Grand Historian, writes that he became arrogant and cruel, going out on marauding expeditions with tens of slaves or young men who were hiding from the law, and murdered and seized the belongings of his people for sheer sport. Of confirmed victims, there was over 100 murders. These deaths were known across the kingdom, bringing fear to the people and terrifying them from leaving their homes at night. Fearful of seeking help, the people kept to themselves, believing that they would not be heard and persecuted for pointing the finger at royalty. However, one son of a victim of Pingli told the emperor of what his nephew had been doing. Finally, Pingli was caught, and the courts wanted to execute him for his crimes. The emperor, whom was also Pingli's uncle, could not bear to have his nephew killed, and instead he was stripped of his title and exiled. There is no documentation that I could find that spoke or wrote about what happened after his exile. Usually serial killers feel the need in time to kill again, like an itch that can't be satisfied until scratched. He probably did go off and continue raiding and killing, but since he was stripped of his title, the fame that came with his killings before was lessened, or just not recorded at the time. Did you enjoy this video? Want to support this channel? Check out my Patreon page where I create videos on cryptids, hauntings, abductions, serial killers, and much more. If you can't support me there, please like, comment, and subscribe here. I'd like to thank my supporting Patreon this far, and I hope you all have a good night.